spirit guide. Good morning.
Good morning.
How's everybody this morning?
Doing good.
Good. My computer wants to be slow. Well, all right. Praise the Lord. Shall we open up with a word of prayer?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Heavenly Father, we just come to you this morning to give you thanks, Lord, to give you glory, honor, and praise. We thank you for choosing us, oh God. Thank you for being our God. Thank you for loving us like only you can, God. Thank you, Father, that you've given unto us everything that we need that pertains to life and to godliness, Lord. We thank you for loving us with an unfailing love today, oh God. Thank you for blessing us with supernatural gifts and abilities that we can fulfill the calling for which you've given unto us. We ask you right now, Father God, that you would just anoint this service, God, that you would have your way, that you would be glorified and edified in every way, oh God, that we would be drawn close to you, that we would be more equipped to resist the enemy, that he would flee from us, oh God. So we give you thanks, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Difference.
God reigns. Lord, you reign above every name.
Can we ask the Lord to do that this morning? blow my mind. Come on, sing it with me. Say, blow my mind.
Blow my mind.
Now tell them, do the impossible.
Do the impossible.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. All right. I'm not sure who's bringing the word this morning, but we are excited to hear what thus saith the Lord through Apostle Lawrence Nussbaum Sr., Pastor Monette.
Somebody.
Glory to God. Amen. We pray for a powerful anointing to rest upon the dynamic duo as they bring forth the word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God can do anything. Ooh. He gonna have to do this.
God can do anything. Hallelujah. But fail. So here's the funny thing, right? Apostle was teaching on Thursday, and I thought I heard him say, "New Swans, y'all gonna have to get Sunday." But it was kind of like in the flow of stuff. So Larry said, "Who's speaking Sunday?" I said, "I think it's us. I'm not sure. I thought I heard him say that." It's like while he was in the midst of his flow and stuff. I said, "Nevertheless, we'll just be ready." Amen. How many know you gotta always be ready? So, you know, many of us, we read daily devotionals and constantly reading the word on a daily basis. So you should never be without a word. Because if you read it every day, something, you got to have something coming out of that, right?
Amen.
I mean, you ought to be getting something from your daily reading. So you should always have something that you can share with others of what the Lord is saying through the word of God to you. Amen?
Amen.
So we were reading, and we were reading about the true vine in John 15 and 7. So that's where we're going to go. We're going to go to John 15 and 7 because I remember when we were reading, I was like, "Oh, that's good." That's just good. So when the word get good to you, you want to share. You know, when you see a good movie, you run around, you tell everybody about that great movie that you saw. Amen.
Right.
And just singing that song, God can do anything. Amen. When I'm thinking about John chapter 15 and we can go there. Amen. I'm thinking about how the ability, how we got to trust more in the ability of God.
All right.
Amen. And if we stay connected, we can do that. Praise God. So John chapter 15. Let me just get there myself because I was too busy talking.
You going to start at verse 1 or what?
Yep, I'm going to start at verse 1. It says, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of the word I have spoken to you. Remain or abide," that means remain, "in me as I also remain or abide in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit." Somebody say much fruit.
Much fruit.
Much fruit. "Apart from me, you can do nothing. But if you do not remain in me, you are like a branch that is thrown away and withers. Such branches are picked up and thrown into the fire and burned. If you remain in me and my words remain in you, ask whatever." Somebody say whatever.
Whatever.
"You wish."
Yeah.
"And it will be done for you." Say, "It will be done."
It will be done.
Amen. Hallelujah. "This is to my Father's glory that you bear much fruit." This is Jesus talking, right? "Showing yourselves to be my disciples. As the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you, that your joy may be complete." Come on, say complete joy. Thank
complete
you, Lord.
Complete joy.
"My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, that you lay down one's life for one's friend."
Amen.
That means you got to die, y'all. You got to die to some things. "You are my friends if you do what I command. I no longer call you servants because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends. For everything that I learned from my Father, I have made known to you. You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you so that you might go and bear fruit. Fruit that will last. And so that whatever you ask in my name, the Father will give you. This is my command. Love each other." Amen. 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 Praise God. We're talking about trusting in the ability of God. Hallelujah. So all through this scripture, there's some great benefits that we see here, right? Amen. Glory to God. We see some great benefits all through this scripture. We stay connected to Him. We bear fruit, right? But not just fruit, much fruit. Much fruit. Amen. We're not going to just bear fruit, but we'll bear a lot of fruit. Amen. So I don't know about you. I like a lot. Amen. I like a lot, you know. So when I hear much fruit, I'm thinking a lot of love. Amen. I'm thinking a lot of joy. And he said complete joy, full joy that we'll get. These are benefits of staying connected to the vine, staying connected to Christ. He is the vine.
Amen.
I remember giving this example before about our cell phones, that, you know, we rely so much on it. We depend upon it so much nowadays. I don't even remember what it was like not having a cell phone and having a landline. And my mom's trying to call because she's having trouble getting on. She's telegramming me, but she don't know it. Amen. She's probably trying to message me. Amen. So, praise God. Hallelujah. So we are so attached to our cell phone, but we don't know how to function, it seems, without it. We abide in it, in a sense. We depend on it so much. You don't remember, pretty much a lot of people don't remember numbers anymore, right? Because we're so dependent upon it. And when you don't have it, you feel like you're lost. But the phone is one thing. If you don't have the charger, that's a whole nother thing. Because you can have the phone and forget the charger and it dies. Because it needs the source, right? It needs that source of power. Amen.
She's not picking up.
Okay. I'm not sure what's going on with mom's phone. But anyway, that's how it is. We got to be so dependent on God, so dependent, so connected to the source, our source, Jesus Christ, so connected to the vine so that we can bear much fruit. I'm loving that much fruit right there. Hallelujah. I don't want to just bear fruit. I want to bear a lot of fruit. Amen? And see, we just barely bear fruit when we're just barely hanging on to the vine. Amen. Barely connected. Not totally connected. Not totally connected to the source, but just kind of halfway there. Amen. If you ever seen a plant and you've seen some leaves are very firmly on the vine and then some are just kind of halfway there hanging on. Amen. Well, you know that one that's hanging on ain't going to have much life unless it gets totally connected, whether you physically make sure it's engrafted and connected to the vine, or it's going to eventually fall off and die. Actually, while it's still hanging there, it's dying. If you can just get that picture in your mind of a plant that has a leaf or a branch and it's just kind of sitting there and just withering, right? We don't want to be like that. We want to be connected. We want to be firmly connected to the vine. Amen? Because, see, when you're totally connected to Him, then everything He's able to do, we say God can do anything. Well, so can you. Because you're connected. Amen? There's nothing too hard for our God. And there'll be nothing too hard for you because you're connected. Amen? If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you shall ask what you will and it shall be done unto you. We're talking about good coming to me in 2023 and we're going to see in 2023, huh? We got to be connected. Amen. We got to stay connected. We got to stay attached. Amen. We can't be going off and doing our own thing. Amen. Or barely there, halfway there, in and out and all of that good stuff. You got to be connected. You got to make up your mind. I'm going to stay connected to Christ. I'm going to stay connected to my ministry because they're preaching the word. If the words are being preached there, that's where you want to stay connected. Amen. To the word of God. Amen. Jesus is the word. Praise God. Hallelujah. But you shall ask what you will. See, if you're connected to the vine, you're not going to just ask for any old thing. You're going to ask according to the will of God. Amen? Because you're going to know His will while you're connected to Him. So therefore, you're not going to ask some crazy stuff.
Amen.
I love how it says, whatever then you ask. It's going to be done. Say, it will be done. I will see in 2023. I will see. I will see. Hallelujah. In 2023, it shall be done. Amen. Good is coming to me in 2023. Right. It shall be done. Hallelujah. Because I'm staying connected. I don't know about you, but I'm staying connected. Hallelujah. I'm linking up with the Holy Ghost. Amen. And I'm going to stay connected. Amen. Like they say, white on rice. I ain't going nowhere. Praise God. Hallelujah. I love how the Message Bible says it. The Message Bible says it like this. I'll just read it. It says, I am the vine. You are the branches. When you're joined with me and I with you in relation, the relation intimate and organic, the harvest is sure to be abundant. The harvest is sure. I will see. In 2020, sure, I'm sure of it. I'm confident. Hallelujah. That I will, that good is coming to me. Hallelujah. I'm sure of it. The harvest is sure to be abundant. I will. Hallelujah. And I'm confident in the fact that I bear much fruit and my joy is complete and full. Amen. I'm sure of it. It says, separated, you can't produce a thing. Separated, you can't produce a thing. That's why it's important we stay connected to the body of Christ as well. Because when we separate ourselves and we kind of drift and go our own way and try to figure out by ourselves how to do things, you know, you end up, you know, can't produce anything. You're wondering why there's no production in your life.
You know, I don't... really want to mess up with flow with you, but as you were sharing, I just was thinking about how, you know, we got a lot of orchards and stuff around here in New York, you know, outside of York and whatnot. And so when you go through these like cherry places where they sell cherries, and then you say the grapevines and all this, we don't say as much grapes, but anyway, it's basically on the same vine there, same thing, because it's right. It's the grapevine is actually it's a small tree, and so it has to go through seasons. And so as you were ministering, I was thinking of some of the folks that's in our covenant, that's in our ministry, and how we go through different seasons. And when the grapes go through those certain seasons, when we go through those different seasons, you know, it has to be pruned. And so Jesus told his disciples that you got to follow me, pick up your cross and follow me. So there's a time of pruning. There's a time of dying to the self life. We live in two worlds. And so the enemy wants to keep us focused in the natural perspective, instead of allowing the Holy Spirit to lead us into those areas where he's trying to show us you need to be cut right here. You need to be pruned. You need to deal with your attitude. You need to deal with, you know, your lack of self-esteem or whatever the issue may be, or just into things.
Right.
Instead of allowing the Holy Spirit to lead you into his presence and deeper into the word. Man, because, you know, there's issues. We all have issues. Mm-hmm. We all have to deal with our self-life, deal with the flesh. We created for two worlds, and the enemy doesn't want us to pick up the cross. The cross represents a death to live again.
Amen.
So we got to die to those things. We have to allow, as we want to grow more fruit, there's a season that the grapes have to go through. And when it comes to towards the winter, comes a time of pruning.
Yeah.
And you know, the vine dresser has to cut some stuff.
Yes.
Why? It's preparing for the next season. And we're entering in a new season. And so we had to go through some things last season. We had to get cut. We had to deal with some issues. We had to deal with attitude. We had to deal with low self-esteem. We had to deal with some things that the enemy had assigned to us even before we even knew we was born. He was waiting to try to attach us some things and cause us not be successful and bring forth much fruit. And that's what God is wanting from us. He's wanting us as believers. I don't know where you are in your walk with Christ. I don't know where you are in your level of submission to your leadership, because that's the issue. See, the cross represents the horizontal and vertical. Vertical meaning our connection with God, and then horizontal is connection with one another, right, or with our leader.
Right.
Or with those that we're trying to follow or we're trying to lead. So that's natural man to man, or woman to woman, and then that's man to God. And so our issue is that cross is helping us to realize I got to be become more spiritual.
Yeah.
See, because what brings life to the vine, or what brings life to the grapes on the vine,
yeah,
is the Spirit. Is the Holy Spirit. Is that life coming from the soil? Is that life coming from the foundation, who is God?
Hallelujah.
And so God is the one, and he through Christ is considered those branches, Lord, so to speak.
Right.
And causing that fruit, causing the growth, that those grapes, causing whatever that fruit might be. It might be cherries. What, don't matter what but the vine is the issue, is because it's Christ.
Right.
And Christ, the Holy Spirit, is the one that brings the life to us and through us. It's with Christ is in heaven, sitting at the right hand of the Father. So now we fail to realize that it's the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. So we want to so call ourselves picking up the cross, but we don't want to submit to a leader. We don't want to submit to a man or woman of God, because they just trying to control me. No, we're trying to help you get controlled by the Spirit, because we've been controlled by the flesh. So now that you die to the self life, you got to get connected to a body of Christ that you don't mind somebody that's tell you what to do, because you know they're not trying to hurt you. You know, you cutting me. You know, you go to the doctor. If the doctor don't know what he's doing and he hadn't been trained, you don't want him cutting on you. But if you know somebody's been in prayer, you know somebody's been in the Word, you know somebody's been spending time with God.
Come on.
It don't matter if you don't like how he look or how he sound. Long as he knows know his gift, he know he is in Christ.
Yeah.
So I just want us to understand, let some pruning take place, so you can bring forth much fruit. Jesus. See, that's the issue. People like this Zoom because, you know, we don't get to touch you and get to see what you're doing and how you're dealing, you know. So we want to try to hide behind the Zoom. Sometimes I can't wait till we get back in the building, because, see, folks got a problem. Even the Zoom is crazy now. Folks don't even want to get on Zoom. It's like, really? I know we all got life. We all got things to do. But it's about growing. It's about growing and knowing who we are in Christ, and we have to be pruned. And the way we get pruned is you got to be touched, you got to be cut, you got to be dealt with. So if nobody can speak into your life and help you see that you're fumbling with your finances, you're fumbling with your relationship with your wife, you're fumbling with that, on and on and on. No, we're not trying to kill you. We're just trying to prune. We're trying to help you look at some things to help you strengthen your walk with Christ, strengthen your walk with your children, strengthen your walk in your finances, strengthen your walk in life in general. Dealing with being able to bring forth fruit. It's all about being able to go out now and tell somebody where I am, how I got here, is because I'm doing what I told you to do.
That's
what I'm trying to help you get. It's about surrender. It's about submitting. It's about laying down your life that he will cause you to rise up.
Come on.
That's what the cross is. Pick up your cross. I got to die to some things.
Jesus.
I didn't like, you know, doing different things. It ain't about that. It's about being able to allow the Holy Spirit to deal with your issue. And we all got them. It's called flesh. We created for two worlds. So we got to stay connected to the body of Christ. We got to stay connected to other believers. So folks want to act like, you know, they want to be a maverick all by themselves. No. Who's going to check you?
That's right.
Who's going to check me? We want to be in leadership, but we don't want to be led. Mm. We want to lead. We want to be in charge, but who are you submitted to?
Right.
So this is about growing. It's about being able to bring forth fruit. This is about being able to let somebody deal with those things that you may not fully see in your own self.
Jesus.
Come on, man. I couldn't see sometimes my own issues in my own life growing up in ministry. And some of the older saints had to come in. Hey, baby, what's that? What's that right there?
Yes.
You got a sharp tongue. You got a little attitude, you know. Did you see what you just said in front of everybody about the pastor?
Mm-hmm.
Why do you say that? I thought you supposed to have been his right-hand man.
Come on.
Or whatever.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? So it's about a pruning. It's about a cutting off of the flesh of the old, that the new may come forth, that some things may sprout up. And so we have to deal with some root issues. Some things, you might have low self-esteem, might didn't have a father, might didn't have some lot of things in life. So now God is digging around. One scripture was talking about how the farmer went and just wasn't producing. So he said, well, give me a little more time. Let me put some manure around it. Let me dig around it. Give me a little more time to work with it.
Yeah.
So this is what we have to do. Allow God to work with you.
Yes.
Allow somebody to speak into your life. See, sometimes that's why people don't want to be close. That's why I realize our ministry was what it will grow so far. But when you start trying to deal with issues, when you start trying to help people bring forth fruit that will bring forth fruit in the kingdom of God and begin to bring glory and honor to God. People got a problem with that. Because we got to pick up the cross. You got to die. You got to die to your attitude. You got to die to, you know, you mad at your father because he wasn't there, or he was aggressive to your mother, or whatever the issues may be. We have to pick up our cross. We have to pick up that word. And the word of God begins to reveal to us. Isn't that ironic how in Genesis it talks about the tree of life was right in the garden. They could have ate anything else, but they ate the tree that God told them not to eat. Why is it that we always want to lean to what God said not to do? That's the flesh. So when we die to the flesh and die to our intellect and our reasoning and our education, our finances, and on and on and on, when we die to those things, then we'll be able to begin to see the fruit of the Holy Spirit. That love, that joy, the peace, long-suffering, temperance, meekness, those things. We don't want to keep seeing the flesh.
Come on.
We want the Holy Spirit to bring forth fruit. That there are people who want to follow us. Listen, you can always tell when somebody don't really want God. Because when you start talking about some things, about loving people and loving your enemy, love my enemy, no, I want to cut his throat. No, that's not the spirit. That's the flesh.
Jesus.
That's No, you got to die to that. So I didn't mean to mess up your message. I didn't mess around. Go ahead. And, well, I'm just wondering. I was trying to highlight something.
Our message.
Yeah, well.
Praise God. Ooh, teaming up.
Jesus.
Praise God. So yes, like there is a pruning process. That's the part that people don't like. That's the part that doesn't feel good. Sometimes you got to just say, ouch, right? And keep on moving. Don't get offended. Just be like, ouch. Man, that must have been a pruning time for me, pruning moment for me. Amen?
You got to know that it's out of love.
Absolutely.
You know, and it's so ironic because when we start talking about this, I keep thinking about all the different vineyards and stuff that we, you know, on all the orchards and fruit places that we drive through in the back parts of outside of York. And it's like, you know, some of the trees are stumps.
Yeah.
And at one time they gave fruit.
Right.
Ooh, glory to God.
Come on now.
At one time it produced. Hey, glory to God. There's people in the kingdom of God that one time they produced. But something, things in life and things that happened that they may have been overpruned. Now you go by and you see this big old orchard, but you see a few of them that's year after year, they still ain't produced nothing. They didn't dig them up, but they're trying to see. They're trying to hold on and see if something will come from that stump. And that's what happens a lot in the church. Mm-hmm. We got a lot of stumps. A lot of folks have been through some stuff. They allow life circumstances and situations to cause them to be unfruitful.
Right.
And so now they're mad at God, mad at the church, and don't realize that you have to begin to produce again. You have to get to the place, dig deeper.
Jesus.
Search for that living water.
My.
Hallelujah.
My.
Anybody been there? Anybody know what I'm talking about? You ever been in a place where life is just heavy on you?
Come on.
And you feel like you didn't know what to do? What you need to do is begin to pick up your cross. You got to die. You got to lay down and say, Lord, not my will, but your will be done. Show me, Lord. Where am I not producing? Where am I messing up and not helping somebody else to produce?
Come on.
Because that's what this is all about. We want to birth some more fruit.
Jesus.
We want somebody else to begin to birth something for the kingdom of God.
Jesus.
To bring life and not death.
Jesus.
So when I die to myself,
ooh,
I want to bring life to you. So when
that's
I,
it.
Some
that's
things
right
that,
there.
Things
that's
that, it. You know, don't go always go my way because I see it a certain way. No, but when I get in the word of God, when I allow the Holy Spirit, to begin to show me some things in the scripture, when he begin to show me, when he begin to show that I'm not bringing forth the fruit that he desires, then that's an issue.
Lord have mercy.
Then I have to let him prune me. I have to let him cut me.
Jesus.
Have to let him deal with me, because there's those some things that the enemy has assigned before I was even formed in my mother's womb. He wanted to say, yeah, I'm gonna try to get this one. But God said, not so. I got plans for
hallelujah.
This one.
Hallelujah.
So now we got to yield.
Yes, God, yes.
We got to say, yeah, Lord, cut me.
Jesus.
Yeah, God, prune. Those. Prune. What's not of you, God, cut them dead limbs. Cut that stuff off me, God.
Yes.
That stuff I've been carrying, you know, low self-esteem, hurts, wounds, things that was said to me,
yes,
you know, as a young person, whatever it might be, as
yes,
a young woman, as a young man, you got to let it go. You got to let that stuff and then begin to bring forth much fruit.
That's right.
To
that's
the kingdom
right.
of God.
That's right. That's right, and that's how they know we're his disciples too, because we have to bear this fruit. It's not just for us. It's so that others can see. Amen. I think it was Pastor Cordy said one time, what would your fruit taste like if someone picked from your tree? Would it be bitter or would it be sweet? Amen.
Or would it be bittersweet? No.
Bittersweet. What kind of fruit are you bearing? Amen. So it's not just for us. It's so that we can be known as his disciples. They'll know that we are Christians by our love. We got to abide in his love. Amen. We got to stay connected. Amen. So pruning is a good thing. Pruning is a good thing. It may hurt when you get snipped here and there, but it's a good thing. And the thing is in life, we understand that. We understand it when it comes to planting. We understand it when it comes to cutting dead ends off the edges of our hair. We understand that when we do that, it grows back quicker and stronger, right? So let's be open to the pruning process so we can come back stronger than ever. Amen. And bear much fruit. Much fruit. Much fruit.
I started with talking about the season. When you start talking about the cutting, it reminded me of what I was, you know, sometimes I go on a tangent. But I ask you, forgive me on that. But the focus is like you said, parts of the tree sometimes are still alive, you know. But it's a pruning, and you're cutting in that particular area because you know that the season's about to change. So when the season changes, when the summer comes back again, now that part that you thought was dead or dying is going to bring forth fruit now because you snipped off the old.
Jesus, thank you, Lord.
You snipped off the part that it brought forth. Okay, but now it's been around. Now it's time to prune that, cut that to bring more fruit for the next season.
Yes, Lord.
So what season are you in?
Hey, come on now.
What season are you in? That pruning season? Are you in that cutting season? God trying to cut some things out of your life?
Jesus.
Huh? Or are you in that season where you're growing? Come on, different fruit in different places. We're different people. We're in different areas. So I don't know. You may not be where I am. And it's okay. But you got to know what season you in.
Huh? Come on now. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. I was reading in the Message Bible. Again, it said, separated, you can't produce anything. Anyone who separates from me is dead wood, gathered up, and thrown on the bonfire. But if you make yourselves at home with me, and my words are at home with you, you can be sure that whatever you ask will be listened to and acted upon.
That's it.
I don't know what you're believing God for, but the answer is in how you are abiding. Amen. The answer is how connected are you? Amen. Hallelujah. You got to be linked up. You got to be attached. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You got to make yourself at home with him. Praise God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And then in that, you can be sure, like I said, that good is coming to you in 2023. You can be sure that you're going to see the things that you've been praying for in 2023. So if you haven't been seeing God move like you know he can move in your life, ask yourself, am I abiding in him? Am I attached? Like really attached? I'm not just hanging off. Like a little branch, just kind of, I'm hanging on, but I'm barely hanging on. Amen? Right. No, get connected. Get totally connected. Not just to this ministry and to our leadership, but to the Word of God. Get connected to what the Word says. Get connected to the vine. Amen. Whatever you ask, it will be listened to and acted upon. This is how my Father shows who he is. That's the part I like in the Message Bible. It says, this is how my Father shows who he is. Huh? This is how my Father shows off. Glory to God. Woo!
Can I say
God.
Something?
Yes.
As you were saying that, I was thinking about so much is going through my spirit, through my mind, through my heart, is that, you know, a lot of times want to use us as an example, is that because it seemed like when we have our less, that's when we got the most.
Wow.
Because it's like we've given more than we ever have given, and we keep getting more. He gives us. He gives to those that will give. And see, that's the problem. A lot of folks have issues because they don't want to give the fruit that they have. God has planned to do with this ministry because we're givers. We give what we have. You know, it doesn't matter if I got 2 apples, I'm gonna give one of them away. I'm not eating both of them. And so the issue is, this is what a lot of people are struggling in the body of Christ, is because they don't understand that He wants us to show for who He is. Our Father's a giver.
Yes.
Jesus, God gave His Son. Son gave His life. The Holy Spirit is in us to help us give back what He's given unto us. Come on. May not have what I want and some of the things I desire, but I have nothing. I don't have no needs.
That's right.
All my needs are met. Everything I need, He supplied. And so my issue is, if you're struggling with some stuff, could it be that you're stealing something, you're robbing from God, you're not producing, you're not giving the fruit that He has? Come on, little 10%. We struggling. No, he said, will a man rob God? How have you robbed me? In tithes and offering? Come on. I hate, you know, almost in the natural, I hate to talk about that because people take it wrong. They think, oh, yeah, here we go again. Here we go, preacher for money. But let me help you. I just told you we not lacking for nothing because we're givers. And we got to start at the foundation. You got to start at the soil.
Yeah.
The soil of this thing, to make this tree grow, you got to plant some seed. Mm-hmm. You got to get to a place where you understand. You got to give God what He said in His word. He said, a tenth belongs to me. He said, everything in the garden you can have, everything you can eat, that tree right there, just don't mess with that. That 10% right there, don't mess with that. That's mine.
Basically.
And that's where we struggle, because we want to eat the seed. We want to eat the tithe. We want to eat the thing that causes us to grow, causes us to mature, causes us to see and trust God for who He is.
Huh.
He's our source. You know, we already sang the song, God can do anything. Yeah, he can't get you to give your tithe, though. That's a struggle. No, give the
10%. Come on now.
And I guarantee you that you'll be blessed beyond measure. We're living examples. Come on. Living examples. I remember when we could barely rub stuff together. We was barely making ends meet, trying to electric bill this, that. But we never stole God's tithe. Mm-mm. And He turned that thing around. That's why we could sing that the theme for 23. We're going to see. Huh? God gonna bless. He's God blessing already.
Coming to me.
He blessed us at the end of 22, going into 23. Because we were doing what He told us to do. How about you? Stay connected to the vine. Mm. Humble yourself. Fight the good fight of faith. Know that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all you may ask or think, according to the power that works in you. Is the Holy Spirit bringing life into that tree of yours? It's the Holy Spirit, y'all. That's why I'm realizing. Got to humble myself.
Yes, Lord. Thank you.
I've been learning more and more. Don't matter. The higher you trying to go up, the lower you got to go down. The more you got to say, Lord, I need you.
That's right.
I got to pray. I got to dig deep, check my own roots out.
Mm.
Getting that word like never before. May not always flow the way you flow. May not have it the way you got it. But I got it. I'm bringing forth some fruit. Somebody being blessed from our life, from our ministry. Hello. So stop worrying about other folks and check your own fruit. Mm. Check your own house.
Mm.
Check where you are. Am I bringing forth something for God?
Right.
Am I giving God what He asked me?
Mm-hmm.
Huh? We wanna look at the preacher. Say, that's all I talk about. Yeah, but that's why you broke as hell. I'm sorry. Did I say that?
Mm-hmm.
You keep robbing. You can't rob God and think he gonna bless you. You can't. I did it. I tried it. Come on. Before I became a minister, before I really understood what this life is all about, being connected to the vine.
Come on.
Picking up your cross.
Come on.
I try to do it in my own strength. Work hard and try to get money. No. Yeah, he gives you the wisdom and he gives you the ability. To go get, see, the thing of it is, we always want a handout. No, but you got to do something. You got to do something. You got to be willing to work with your hands. You can't be lazy.
That's right.
The Bible says, look at the ant, you sluggard. They prepare in the winter. They got stuff in the summer. They're preparing the summer for the winter.
Come on.
So why are we not preparing if we can't even follow an ant?
Oh.
Ant gives. Ant does what needs to be done. Come on. So we need to get to our place where we're saying, okay, God, what is it in me? I took my eyes off of you.
Right.
Love you. You're my wife. Thank God for you. But when I took my focus off of you and started looking at me and said, how do I line up? Where do I need to pick up my cross?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Where do I need to die?
to these attitudes, to the self life, those things that were, you know, those little thorns, those things that was plugging in my flesh that hooked me to the things of the past. You got to shake that stuff. You got to get pruned.
Shake it.
You got to get pruned. We got to deal with some stuff. I don't know what your issue is. Might be family issues. Might be stuff from generational curses. Whatever it is, you got to get pruned. You got to turn it over to God. And even in the church, sometimes, you know, I had stuff I was hurt in the ministry. And so therefore, we wind up carrying that stuff. No, no, get pruned. Get cut. Cut that stuff off. Stop. Ah. The devil using that to keep you from growing, to keep you from helping others come to the kingdom, helping others grow in God, helping others have bring forth some fruit, much fruit, because of what happened to you in the church. No, no, no. That wasn't the church of Jesus Christ. That wasn't the church of God. That was the church of the flesh, or the world, the devil. Mm. So let me help you.
Come on.
We got to get to the place where we stay connected.
That's right.
To the vine.
Yes, sir.
Got to get in that word like never before. I told you before in the past, that was always my struggle, reading. But I think I read more last year and into this new year than ever before.
Come on.
And I'm seeing a change. I'm seeing growth. I'm seeing fruit. Huh? I'm talking about my own life. Not trying to push fruit coming through my wife or through my kids. No, no. The love of God. Whew. Anybody know what I'm talking about? As you begin to prune and deal with your issues, you begin to see the Spirit of God begin to grow you up.
Jesus.
Money ain't no thing now. Money ain't an issue. I care about money. It's just money. It's just money. But when you begin to do what God tells you to do, there's a joy that's unspeakable that goes beyond things in the natural. Goes beyond things that you feel, that you see with your senses. It's spiritual. It's so heavy when you begin to realize that you're connected to the vine. There's times when your emotions are all over the place. You feel like you want to laugh, but you're crying. You feel like you want to cry, but you're laughing. Because the anointing and the presence of God, His goodness.
Yes.
Because of your obedience, because of your surrender, Jesus. Because of your staying committed and submitted. The Spirit of God begins to cause your flesh to line up. Say, ha, woo, no weapon that's formed against me gonna prosper.
That's right.
And every voice, I heard you, devil. Every voice that will try to rise, I'm going to condemn it. Why? Because I'm walking in obedience. I'm bringing forth much fruit.
Connected.
The fruit of the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
I'm going to love in spite of, even though everybody talk about me and say I ain't did nothing for them. I love you. Woo, glory to God.
Jesus.
Fruit. Come on, bring forth much fruit.
Much fruit.
Let somebody prune you. Let somebody deal with your issues. That's the problem. One went away. Oh, why you say it like that? It don't matter how I say it. The issue, you don't want to deal with it.
Ooh.
I could text it to you and you get an attitude. I could leave a phone, you get an attitude. No, no. It's the word of God. We got to be dealt with. We got to get this flesh hung to the cross. That's the problem. Isn't it ironic how Jesus asked his disciples in the gospel? He asked them, he said, who do men say I am? They say all this. Some say Elias, some didn't. And then, so then Peter, you know, with his big mouth stuff, he going to say, well, you the Son of the living God. He said, oh, yeah, you didn't know that. You didn't get that on your own, but my Father gave that to you. And then right after that, Peter turns around and Jesus began to now he going to go in deep. See, it's a shame when we as believers, as ministers, when we try to share ourselves, when we try to share what God is trying to take us, when we try to share the vision, people got a problem with that. He said, because then Peter, he going to tell Peter, well, hey, listen, now I got to go to the temple. I got to go and be dealt with by the, you know, the Pharisees and Sadducees, all those, the scribes and all them. Going, I have to go, and I'm going to be hung on the cross. I'm going to die. And Peter said, oh, no, not you, Lord. What did just that quick? He had to tell him Satan. He called him the devil. First of all, he had a revelation. Now all of a sudden, he went right into the flesh. Come on, we gotta die. We gotta pick up our cross.
Come on.
We gotta be pruned. So Jesus had to rebuke him. He said, get out of here. What you talking about? No. I'm gonna do what my Father told me to do.
That's right.
How about you? Are we doing what the Father called us to do?
Yeah.
We gotta die to the self-life. We have to pick up our cross. Here we talking about a tree.
Come on.
You know, it's a small, when you talk about a vine, it's a small tree, but it brings forth fruit.
Yes.
That will give life. So when we begin to allow the tree, when we pick up our cross, it causes us to bring a spiritual tree within us.
Yes.
That will bring forth spiritual fruit.
Love.
That will help others.
Temperance.
to be if they just open up and receive.
That's right.
So Peter had to be put in check. Sometimes folks don't want to be put in check. Isn't that ironic, Peter? He hung on, though. So what is God doing to you? What is God saying in your life?
All right.
Where is he trying to put you in check? You still struggling with the tithe? You still struggling with your 10%? You still struggling with your offering? You still struggling with missions? You still struggling? Huh? That's the smallest little thing that will bring, when we give that small little thing, it will bring much fruit.
Much fruit.
Much fruit. I'm trying to tell you from example. My wife and I, sometimes we barely was making it, but we wouldn't steal God's money. We wouldn't steal God's tithe. We wouldn't steal that offering. We wouldn't do it. And till this day, we still trying to figure out, Lord, you just awesome. God can do anything.
He can
do anything but fail.
That's it.
There's nothing too hard for him. And we're realizing, just keep your focus on the Lord. Growing in God. Continue to pick up your cross. Deal with your issues. Allow yourself to be pruned by your leaders. Come on, especially when you know you got godly leaders. I've been under different so many different leaders all around the world, because I was, you know, a Christian in different places when I'm in the military, and I dealt with different leaders, and I had to realize, man, that God uses people. He uses people to help deal with our issues. And how would you know you even got an issue if nobody told you? See, and you always got an attitude because you don't want nobody to tell you, you know. Now, here it is. I'm at the church and I'm going to go over here and preach, and I got like a big goober hanging out my nose, and I don't want nobody to tell me I got a goober. No, we got to be willing to let somebody speak into our life. Let somebody prune us. Let somebody cut us.
That's it.
I remember the scripture where it said, where God had told Abraham to, you know, he had to circumcise everybody. That was going to be the sign of his blessings to them. And so even when then Joshua took over for Moses, and he had to circumcise them again. Because now the old folks died out. So now the new folks, the new generation had to get cut.
Jesus.
People don't want to be cut. People don't want their issues to be dealt with. Well, I'm a grown man. You know, you can talk to me that kind of way. No, it ain't about talking to you that kind of way. It's about I'm trying to help you grow spiritually. We used to the flesh. We used to carnality. Let me go ahead and let you.
Amen. Amen. So if we want to leave you with anything, we want to leave you with this. Stay connected. Stay connected to the source. Amen. The source of life. Amen. It's vital and absolutely necessary. Your life depends on it. You got to hang on like your life depends on it, because it does. Amen. It's vital. It's necessary. It's essential for you to stay connected. Hallelujah. To stay connected to the vine. Praise God. So that you can bear much fruit. Not just fruit, much fruit. Hallelujah. So that others can see the glory of the Lord upon your life and be saved. Amen. That's what it's about anyway. Reaching souls for the kingdom of God. As Sister Betty always says, it's time to go fishing. Well, you can't go fishing looking like, you know, no fruit. Amen. No fruit in your life, no maturity. And we're talking about the fruit of the Spirit. Amen. Blooming from us. Praise God. Hallelujah. And the only way you want to get that is by staying connected. Amen. You got to abide in Christ. Stay connected. Bear much fruit. As it says in Galatians 5, we know what the fruit of the Spirit, amen, love, joy, peace, long-suffering, temperance, right, meekness, kindness, hallelujah, self-control, right, all of those things we only get by abiding, by staying connected to the vine, by staying in his word, amen, and then while you're doing that, whatever you ask, it will be done. And it will be according to his will, because you're abiding in his will and in his word. Praise God. Hallelujah. We got to surrender everything to Christ. The branches are totally surrendered to the vine. They have no control. They're totally surrendered to the vine, to the source of life. And if they are cut off, they won't die. Amen. You don't want to be in church still dying. Come on now. You don't want to still be up on all this word and still dying, barely hanging on. Get attached. Come on. Get connected. Stay connected. Hallelujah. You want to be dependent on Christ just like those branches are dependent upon the vine. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So we can just encourage you today. Stay connected. Bear much fruit. Amen. And remember, like I said, that's how the Father shows up. That's how he shows who he is. Amen. By allowing you to bear much fruit. Praise God. It's all to his glory when we produce much fruit. Amen. In his name. Praise God. And then they'll know that we are his disciples. Because again, our goal and our only goal here is not to be on this earth, as Apostle Park always says, to be air suckers. Amen. But to lead people to Jesus Christ. We can't lead them if we're not bearing no fruit. Amen. Hallelujah. So stay connected. Stay connected to the vine. Amen. I don't know if you have anything else, but we just want to encourage you today that if you're connected, you're going to be all right. And don't trip when you get clipped. Amen. Don't trip when you get clipped. Just say ouch and grow. Amen. Amen. So we're going to leave you with that. Praise God. We love you. Appreciate you. We want to remind you that we're going to celebrate our man and woman of God next week, next Sunday at the 11 a.m. service and the 4 p.m. service. So get ready to celebrate them. 19 years of ministry, y'all. 19. Woo! Come on. That's worth celebrating.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And I don't know if we've been with, we haven't been with you the whole 19, but a majority of it, at least 16, 17 of it, I think. And we're excited. So we love, appreciate you. Go ahead, Dad.
No, well, probably longer than that, because I'm counting the years before you fully submitted, because you were, we were spending time together. Amen.
Yeah. Wow.
Forgot about that.
You know, but hey, one of the reasons why we still going is because we are connected to him. And when, because we connected to him, me and Cordy are connected to each other. And because we connected to each other, we also joined together in purpose. And so, you know, that's why it's working. We, he said, if you ask anything according to my will, and you know, it's part of the scripture you was going, I'll do it. And we're doing his will. Like even now, I think I was talking to Apostle Larry, somebody the other day. Right now, God just got me and my wife, not just, but a lot of our focus is on these young people, man, because they need it. They need us. They need help. You know, I'm tired of older people running around. Hey, that, hey, that. Okay, what are we going to do about it? Man. So we, I guess we, now I didn't even realize we doing working with elementary, middle school, ministering to, let me start over, ministering to elementary, middle school, high school, college, young adults. And Cordy, you ain't gonna believe this. They approached me this morning. It was good I got stuck here at the Y. Wasn't even supposed to be here, but was coming in just to get a workout in. And they had a program here today and wasn't nobody really in position. And I thank God for it. Because mm-hmm. some senior citizens reached out to me, Pastor Cordy. And I'm like, well, that's the only, here we go again saying, can you do something for us around here? We, a bunch of us, want to work out and just stay connected in a fellowship, and we really don't have anything. And I don't know, I'm just wondering, Coach Devin, what do you think about it? So I think it's great when, you know, older folks got a place to go. They want to work out like a social club, you know, just like a group. He said, we got a baseball thing going, but some of the guys want, in the wintertime, we don't have nothing to do. That broke my heart. You know, because these are people want to do, you know, they want to stay connected. You know, we talk about being connected to him, but how many know too, when we're connected to him, he wants us connecting with other people.
That's it.
Amen. That's the cross.
You know, so anyway, I said, what age you talking about? I said, you think I can get in there with y'all? I'm under 60, you know. He just started laughing. So, but I just think it's great. You know, I'm like, I look at Sister Betty, how she participates in the Senior Citizen Center and things like that, just giving them a place to go and stuff to do. amen, or a place to be connected, amen. So when we really connected to him, we're going to be connected to other people. No way you can be connected to him and we have no connection with other people, amen. So anyway, I'm laughing now. So it's like every area now, like now seniors, okay, well, whatever you got to do. And praise God. So we'll see what God want to do there. But anyway, we'll get ready to do our tithes and offerings. And I guess you don't need me to talk about that. You heard enough of that. Praise God. If you didn't hear that, I'm just going to say, let's just receive our tithes and offerings. Amen. And I can't agree anymore. And I know Sister Betty was shaking her head. It's something about when you trust God. I'm telling you, he'll bless you. And it's not to make anybody feel bad and all that, but it's a challenge. I love when people say, hey, I'm a living witness. Amen. Let me tell you what God is doing for me. They overcome by the blood of the Lamb, the word of our testimony. And so, you know, prayfully you got encouraged and not discouraged. But a lot of times when we do talk about money, a lot of preachers don't like to talk about it because of people's perception. But it's in the Bible, so we got to preach it. And I agree with it. And I look all through the Bible. So I pray that, you know, you got not condemned, but convicted. Amen. God, you know, combinations are the devil, but conviction. Somebody say convictions of the Holy Ghost. And
convictions of the Holy Ghost.
God, and really, he even said, try me on this. God said, look, try me. Let me prove to you that I'm real. Let me prove to you, you know, that, hey, I can help you. And so I encourage you to get on that side of the fence. If you're not, and if you are, stay on that side. Don't have one foot over and one foot out. Amen. Be constant. Amen. Amen. So, Father, let's just, you know, we're just sending the offering. We same thing every year. So, Father, we pray over this offering. We pray over the tithes and the missions. And we just thank you for the ability that you give us to attain wealth so that we can not only be sustained in our lives, but help us with their lives by the advancement and sowing into the kingdom. And so we just thank you for those who assembled here today. I just pray that something was said that would challenge them, something that was said would encourage them, something that was said will remind them. There probably is something you already asked them to do or something you already told them. But at the end of the day, we're doing what you're calling us to do. Because if we stay in your will and we ask anything in your will, then you said we can have whatever it is that we ask. But more importantly, before asking anything, I pray we just do your will. I pray that we ask what your will is for our life so that then we can do what the will is for our lives. And as we do so, then you will grant to us our heart's desires. I just pray for the rest of this day, the rest of this week. And I just pray that we be reminded as we celebrate this great holiday, hallelujah, Dr. Martin Luther King's birthday, that we remember it was about sacrifice. It was about service, that he didn't lay his life down just for himself, but that this place can be better. And so we thank you as we remember him tomorrow, as we remember him today, different ceremonies and celebrations, that we remember that he stood for you. Maybe wasn't perfect, for no one on this side of glory is perfect, but he did live like David. There was a cause. And because of that, what he did and what he fought for, many of us are able to go to school with people who don't look like us, go in schools where they didn't want us, sit on the bus wherever we want to, open up businesses, even when they ain't want us to, because he thought that his life was worth losing and laying out so that we can be blessed. And so I pray that we learn something from his life as he learned from Jesus' life. In Jesus' name, somebody say amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. So anyway, I'm glad I got stuck up here because a lot of good came out of it. And Cordy, I don't know if I told you, but our boy won the event. Praise God. He's moving on and amen. So anyway, we're going to get ready to get you out of here because I'm ready to get home. I ain't want to be up here. I wanted to be home. And I want to say that is not my daughter. That's my wife looking all pretty. Let me focus on the camera. Wait, let me. Little pretty little thing. Oh, my. I'm flying home. Who are you and my? Ooh. Ooh, child. Things are going to. Can you, pretty lady, pray us out? Because I don't know who you are in my house. But I know one thing. You better be there when I get there. Tell it, Tony. Don't you leave.
Amen. Happy 19 years of ministry. I thank God.
Yes.
Look at good. Look at her. Look at like she just started. Look at that.
Fresh start.
Yeah. I thank God for what he said. I thank God for that word today. You actually, Monette, you actually gave me a word that I'm going to preach at a women's conference coming up in April.
Wow.
Amen.
And about, well, I'll just share a little bit, just about how you were talking about how you have to get your hair trimmed. Mm-hmm. So it's going to come from there. How, you know, we typically don't like to get our hair trimmed. Like, don't cut my length, don't cut my length. But when you do, it causes you to get new growth from the beginning versus having something dead at the end. So,
All right.
Go with that. So thank you, New Swans, for that word. Thank you for the inspiration. Thank you for the challenge to allow ourselves to be pruned so that we can bear more fruit. Because not only does it cause us to increase and be blessed, but it's also pleasing to God. And that's what we want to do. We want to live a good life, and we also want to please God in everything that we do. So with that, let's pray. Heavenly Father, I just thank you for this time together. I thank you for your saints, God. I thank you for the word today, which challenged us to just go deeper in you, to just lengthen our cords and dig our roots even deeper, that our branches can bring forth more fruit, God, to be pleasing to you, God, whether it be cherries or apples or grapes or raisins. Let it just be love and joy and peace, God, that just emanates from our lives, oh God, that we can just be a light in this world. So I thank you for your word. I thank you for your servants. I thank you for this ministry. I thank you for blessing us to run this race for 19 years. People don't always make it that long, but I thank you for Apostle Park saying yes to you and all the fruit that he has borne over the years from that fruit. We just thank you for it. Thank you, Lord, for the tithes and offerings and the missions, God, that we can continue to run strong and do your work throughout the world. Thank you for trusting us with that assignment, Father. So we just give you blessings, glory, and honor in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Love you guys.
We love you all too.